When she was younger, she would lay in the grass and stare at the clouds. And there she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere. In the trees, the mountains, caves.
Where did he go?
You lost him.
Where is he?
Where did he go?
It's not your fault.
Valravan. Valravan's song.
Listen, focus.
Listen, focus.
You need to focus.
Focus.
The Northmen say that Odin has two ravens. Their names are Thought and Memory. And each day, he sends them out to fly all across the world. Upon their return, they perch on his shoulders and tell him everything they have seen and heard. In this way, he learns of things far and wide, and for this reason, he is called the Raven God. Senua, like Odin, you must seek wisdom through thought and memory if you are to succeed in your quest.
They're there, if you look for them.
Senua, you have the sight.
Senua.
Mother. Just like I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness. But when it did come, it first came for her mother. Senua still sees her face from time to time, hidden in the world. Like she's still watching over. She misses her so much.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father.
With the mark of Valravn and the mark of Surt, you may cross the bridge over the River of Knives to Helheim.
Senua, we each walk these lands, gazing towards different horizons, some of us further than others. Your father cannot see what you see, but there is nothing wrong with seeing the world the way you do.
Open the gate.
say that what we see as a rainbow is the bridge that goes from the world of men to the world of the gods. For now, they say, the frost giants and the mountain giants cannot cross it. But they say that when Ragnarok comes, not a thing in this world will be safe. The Rainbow Bridge will break under the onslaught of the fire giants riding on flaming steeds. Senua, I have seen the fire of Surt spread far and wide, and to our lands. Ragnarok is coming.
It's dangerous. Don't open the gate.
Darkness.
Don't.
She's done it. It's so dark.
It's dark. The darkness.
Only the dead may cross.
There is no one here but me.
Not you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved. They raided these shores. You hear his screams. And now that you're home, he's so far away. They've taken his soul. To these gods you cannot pray. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through his darkness, you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. You fought for love unspoiled by your darkness within. You fought for your dreams. Now there's no way to win. In the head of his corpse lies the seat of his soul. So you must carry his vessel to bring him back home. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through this darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender. Abandon him to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left. The gods made you a warrior for a reason. It's your calling.
Come
the only one that makes any sense. Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
Die!
Betting!
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path. Align yourself to its secrets, and you will find yours. However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess.
Oh, Senua. Your father does not hate me. He just fears the souls in the underworld. He cannot see that they are already afraid. But I am their healer, and I must answer their cries for help, even if it displeases him.
Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls. Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls. High are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sickbed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize, half black and half the color of flesh. And her face, menacing and grim.
Darkness. It's coming. This is your moment.
I'm sorry. I can't watch this.
What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior. You're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
Stormy seas and lost souls.
She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye.
But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us?
Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be?
So stupid.
Everyone hates her. She's a curse.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you. Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just like your sword.
Come on. Dare.
Why go on, when you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined? Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling. A song.
It's not real. It's a trick. It's not real. It's real. Listen to it.
She can't give up.
Delia.
It's not like this.
It's not real. It's real. It's a trick. Don't trust it. Maybe you're already dead.
Who are you?
Do you still believe in me, Shadow?
Thank you. you. Keep going. Ignore the pain. I told you it was a trick. You. I told you. Where are you going? See? There's nothing to follow. Come on.
Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbal, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. Was her world. Like this one. Barren. And lonely.
You're strong. You're getting stronger. You can run. Come on. Where are you going? There's nothing to follow. Dillian's disappeared. You have to be pushing. It's all a deception. He's going to leave again as a sign. Where's he gone? He's got something to tell you.
Where's Dillian?
He knows you're here. Come on. Keep going.
Already disappeared.
Nothing lives here, not even you.
It's pointless.
It's in your mind. You think you can see it. It's in your mind.
Senua, there will be times that you will feel alone and exhausted, like a strange little fish swimming against the tides of the big ocean. But have the faith to let go and let the tide carry you away. Because the whole ocean is your home, and it does not ask you to swim against it.
There he was.
Where is he?
The lone figure of a boy.
He's there, under the tree.
Swordplay under the shade of a tree.
I see him.
She remembers the first time she saw him. To her young eyes, he moved as if dancing. And the world danced with him. The gloom lifted. And for the first time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution. Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
Thank you.
the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break, and he is free. After his escape, Sigmund lives like us, hidden in the forest. His enemy, King Siggeir, believing him dead, as his sister plots revenge.